Commitment 2010 election coverage, and we begin with a series of reports on the candidates running for U.S. Senate called For the Record.
The goal is to sit down with the candidates face-to-face to discuss the issues they would like to face in the Senate, likely face in the Senate during the next year. We begin tonight with Republican Pat Toomey, who's facing Peg Luxick in the primary.
I think I've got the background, the experience, and the skills.
Pat Toomey is a former three-term congressman from eastern Pennsylvania's 15th district, which includes Allentown and Bethlehem. For the record, we asked him and the other candidates for their views on creating jobs and improving the economy, deficit reduction, fiscal reform, immigration, and the cap-and-trade energy bill. On jobs and the economy, Toomey, a conservative Republican, advocates a limited role for government.
Let's not pursue this agenda that's going to cost us jobs. What we need to do instead is get spending under control, because with the size of the government spending and the corresponding deficits, the federal government's just soaking up all the available capital, making it very hard for the private sector to create the kind of jobs that we need.
On reducing the deficit, Toomey opposes increasing taxes.
Raising taxes will really stifle economic growth. In fact, the current administration and, again, both of my potential opponents, Arlen Specter and Joe Sestak, support much higher taxes. I don't.
How do you view the role of entitlements as a way of reducing the deficit?
Social Security and Medicare and Medicaid collectively are going to continue to expand dramatically. People who've paid into a system their whole working life with the promise of a certain set of benefits, they have to get exactly those benefits that they were promised. But that doesn't mean we can't make changes for younger workers.
And on the issue of fiscal reform, Toomey says he was critical of bailouts for giant financial institutions from the beginning.
The big reform that we need is to streamline and expedite the bankruptcy process for very large financial institutions. The idea of taking them into receivership and using a fund to bail them out and prop them up, and basically it's just a way of keeping taxpayers on the hook. This is what a bankruptcy code is for.
On immigration, Toomey says he supports securing the border through a combination of physical and technical barriers. He does not support amnesty for illegal immigrants already here.
Well, I think if people who are here illegally are willing to go back to their country of origin and come through a legal process, then that's a mechanism that's nothing like amnesty.
And on the cap-and-trade energy bill designed to reduce pollution emissions, Toomey sees it as a tax. He points to the additional costs it'll put on businesses and consumers.
The main thrust of it I disagree with. And the main thrust of it is to raise the cost of using energy if the energy is derived from fossil fuels. That's the purpose of it.
Also on energy, Toomey says he supports the use of clean coal technology and natural gas production from the Marcellus coal region of Pennsylvania. Now, of the four candidates, only incumbent Senator Arlen Specter was unavailable for an interview. Now, tomorrow night, we'll hear from his Democratic opponent, Joe Sestak.